Talks.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to Analytics in 15. In today's session, let's take a look at governed data sharing with Amazon DataZone. We all know that data is a new oil, but what good is the oil if you're not able to distribute to people who need it? This is a struggle that challenges many organizations. IT teams want to have tight control on who or why they're using data, whereas the business teams are looking for agility to get answers to questions quickly using data. To help strike this balance, we built Amazon DataZone. I am Priya Tirthani, Senior Product Manager for Amazon DataZone. And with me, we also have Leonardo Gomez, Principal Solution Architect, focusing on data and analytics solutions. Amazon DataZone is a data management service that makes it faster and easier for customers to catalog, discover, share, and govern data stored across different environments. With Amazon DataZone, you can decentralize ownership of data across teams or line of businesses to ensure the right level of privileges and context are met with using that data. So how do you do this? First, govern data across organizational boundaries. Ensure that the right data is accessed by the right user for the right purpose, in accordance with your organization's security regulations. This provides the transparency on data usage across teams and eventually can be audited as well. Next, connect the data people through shared data and tools to drive business insights. This increases the business team's efficiency by collaborating seamlessly across teams and having self-service access to data and analytics tools. With Amazon DataZone, now you can automate data discovery and cataloging with machine learning. This reduces the time required to enrich the data with business context in the catalog and also removes the manual effort needed, which, by the way, introduces potential errors as well. Richer the data in the catalog improves the searching experience and reduces the time of understanding and working with data from weeks to days. How do we do this? So let's look at the main components that DataZone offers. The first one is the business data catalog, where you're able to build the business context for all the data that you want to share across the organization. The second is the data projects that Amazon DataZone introduces, where you can bring the people, tools, and data together so you can work together seamlessly and collaborate efficiently. The third component is the ability to have governance while sharing data. So think of it as a workflow that DataZone offers between the producers and the consumers. So you kind of handshake with the terms and conditions of using the data that are dictated by the producers. And lastly, it's the data portal, where it is a central place for all of the producers or consumers to come there to share the data, to find the data, to understand it, to request access to it, and quickly jump to the tool of your choice. So now that we've seen the four core components, you can bring data from various sources into Amazon DataZone, understand it, build context around it, and also seamlessly jump to the tools like you see here with a Redshift Query Editor, Athena Query Editor, or any other tool of your choice, and work with data seamlessly. And all the access controls are managed by Lake Formation under the covers. So technically speaking, Amazon DataZone extends the AWS analytics stack and helps companies connect and use S3-based data lakes and Redshift-based data warehouses and other data sources without having to build the plumbing across these yourselves. And this way, your data analysts can use Athena or Redshift or any tool of your choice to analyze data that is being governed. Also, it's important to understand that Amazon DataZone is built in an extensible manner, so you can add tools and sources to your choice easily to the catalog and the projects. We know accelerating data insights is a key priority for companies. Companies want to become more and more data-driven, and DataZone is designed to simplify this by giving them one consistent place to work. Here they can search and discover in a rich visual interface, collaborate with data science and analysis teams, query and analyze using data for analytics tools, and govern data consistently. So now I would like to invite our Leo to the conversation, where I want to get some of the answers that I get asked personally from customers and how he's addressing them when talking to them. Hi, Leo. Over the years at Amazon, you've been working with numerous customers, helping them solve analytics challenges. I would like to learn from you on how you're helping our customers with some of these frequently asked questions. Can I shoot some questions your way?
Yeah, sure, please.
Okay. First, let me start with, what are you hearing from customers that's most exciting or interesting to them about Amazon DataZone?
Oh, that's a good question. So in this case, customers love how DataZone has simplified their analytics journey. Okay, what I mean by this is that thanks using DataZone, customers, they're going to be able, or they're able to share data, okay, between line of business in an easy way. This is something that normally takes months. Now they can do it way faster because DataZone offers a way to have data producers and data consumers sharing data with each other. Also, it offers a centralized place in which everybody can go and search for business metadata. And this is very important because that speeds up the process of finding new data assets to innovate with your data. And another thing that is that customers love is the fact that DataZone offers an out-of-the-console experience. What this means is that you don't need to have an IAM user in order to use DataZone. So only with the SSO user, actually your pre-existing SSO user, you can integrate it with DataZone and start using it right away.
Nice. Okay. This is something that gets asked a lot. So when we talk about Amazon DataZone, we always see AWS Glue or Redshift as sources. Have customers asked you about cataloging sources outside of Glue and Redshift? And how do you respond to that?
Yeah. Actually, that is a very common question, as you mentioned. So let me explain it. Okay, so DataZone offers two main components. The first one is the data catalog, and the second one is the data sharing option. Okay, so for the data catalog part, DataZone comes with out-of-the-box integration with Redshift and the Glue catalog. But also, DataZone integrates with Glue crawlers. So what this means is that you can harvest technical metadata using the Glue crawlers from sources like SQL Server, Snowflake, and Oracle, among others. And then once you harvest that metadata, you can enrich it with business information inside of DataZone. Again, also we offer a AppFlow integration, as you mentioned during your presentation, so that allow us to catalog or to harvest metadata from SaaS solution as well. Okay, from, as I mentioned before, from the data sharing point of view, we only support right now a Glue catalog and Redshift, but from the cataloging point of view, we support the sources that are supported by the Glue crowd.
Yeah, well, that's cool. Okay, this comes up a lot, what I'm going to ask next. Have customers asked you about DataZone and how it can help implement a data mesh architecture?
Yeah, I like to call DataZone a data mesh enabler. Okay, so yes, the answer is yes. DataZone is a great a tool to or a solution to speed up the implementation process of a data mesh. Okay, so you can use a friendly UI, okay, to associate different accounts, producers, consumers, with the centralized governance account and having your data mesh. And not only that, as I mentioned before several times, using the data portal, you are going to have those different data domains collaborating with each other. Okay, so what this means is that you can have a data consumer consuming data from a producer account without moving data from one account to the other. So this increases security, of course, and also prevent you to have different copies or multiple copies of the same data asset inside of your company.
Nice. Okay. So as we know, Amazon DataZone is a service that, you know, onboards many users across the organizations. And many customers have already started using, you know, identity providers like Okta, Azure Active Directory, and many other services out there. So have you been asked by customers, like, how do you set up SSO users in DataZone?
Yeah, yeah. Again, another very common question, an important one, okay? Because if you already have your pre-existing Okta deployment or Azure Active Directory, for example, you want to reuse it. That is a common ask. And yes, the answer is yes, of course. DataZone integrates with these SSO providers using AWS Identity Center. Okay, so you can configure this integration when you are creating the DataZone domain or even after. Okay, but making the answer short, yes, it's totally supported. And you need to configure Identity Center in order to have this integration.
So we have customers setting up resources in AWS, and I'm sure one of the questions you're being asked, Leo, is how do I use the pre-existing resources in Amazon DataZone without redoing the work?
Yeah, yeah. So as I mentioned before, DataZone offers out-of-the-box integration with Glue Catalog and Redshift. Okay, so integrating these pre-existing sources with DataZone is pretty simple. Let me walk you through the process. So inside of a data project, okay, you can link or add those data sources inside of your project. Okay, once you have it, you have that integration, you have to run a publication job that is going to harvest the metadata from those sources. And it's going to you're going to have it inside of your project as a draft. Okay, after you enrich all those new data assets, okay, with business related metadata, you can change from draft to publish a state. Once that is you change the status is when those resources are or those data assets are going to be available for the rest of the company. But as you see, it's a three-step process. The first one, harvest metadata. Second, and publish the metadata as part of the business catalog. The third one is validating that all the business information is there. And then is when you release the new data asset to the rest of the company. And when you finalize that last step is when the data consumers can go and search for that specific data asset.
Nice. And all this can be done from the single place, the data portal.
That's correct. From the data portal using your SSO credentials.
Nice. Okay. When do customers use DataZone if they're already using Glue Catalog or Lake Formation?
Okay. So in this case, Glue and Lake Formation are amazing solutions. Okay. The key component here, or the key difference, is that DataZone allows business users, not technical users, to go search for data, share data, and consume data. Okay, that is the main difference between Lake Formation and Glue and DataZone. Lake Formation is amazing to enforce security on top of your data lake, but you need to have somebody from IT configuring all that integration. Okay, with DataZone, you can do it directly. Business user can do it directly using the data portal. And just to let you know, DataZone under the hood use the Glue Catalog and also use Lake Formation. Again, because those are great solutions.
No, this is great, Leo. Thank you so much. This was very informative. And I'm sure the listeners would find it useful as well. Appreciate you taking the time to talk us through these scenarios. And here are some of the QR codes that you can use for your reference. We have the code for our product webpage and also the code for our YouTube playlist, where we will be sharing a lot of assets for you to quickly understand DataZone and its capabilities. Thank you all.
Bye. Thank you.